Kyle Sweeney in the fight. He cuts upfield. And there he goes. Shot out of a cannon. Touchdown.
Dogan on a 35 power as he breaks up the middle. And he's got absolutely Rob Dogan going all.
Look at Troll is out on the right. Look for him.
Hey, we had double wing. He's been back to pass as he throws it long to Schroll, and he catches it.
Oh, yeah.
Touchdown, what a throw, what a catch.
A great catch, a great throw, and Wes Schroll, the go-to guy.
Good evening, everybody. Tim Lito with Mark Shire at Leary Field. And Mark, it's great to be home at Leary Field again, I'll tell you.
It's a beautiful night. I think I'm going to go apple picking after the game here.
Absolutely. And tonight, the Acton Boxborough Colonials get set to take on arch rival of arch rivals at Chelmsford Lions. Both teams won big last week in their openers. And I'll tell you, Mark, we talked last week about the fact that with a brand new team, a brand new defense, that some stars would be born. And I'll tell you, we had Kyle Sweeney and Mikey Duggan and the defensive and offensive line, and that's what last week was all about.
Absolutely. You can't say too much about Kyle Sweeney and Mike Duggan. Kyle Sweeney and Mike Duggan, I think we've watched a lot of AB football, and I think that they had the two most dominant offensive and defensive performances that I've seen. Kyle Sweeney ran for about 220 yards, four touchdowns, and I want to tell you, the 80-yard touchdown run was not the most spectacular of his plays. I mean, he had two touchdowns where he ran through Chelmsford defenders. He bounced off three or four Chelmsford defenders, and he is fast and he's tough. And Mike Duggan, my God, it's like Coach Rocky Nelson gave Mike Duggan the keys to the Woburn huddle. Mike Duggan just blew up the offensive line. So
just incredible.
Great. We hear Kenny Mayer, the velvet voice, just welcoming us to the to Leary Field. But it should be a very, very tough game. You know, we've got Kyle Sweeney, but Chelmsford has Eddie Sheridan, who scored the winning touchdown in the Thanksgiving game and then just took right off again, scored five touchdowns against Westford. So it's going to be really tough. We're going to be doing a lot of blitzing, and that can work both ways, Tim.
Yeah, Chelmsford is a top 20 team and in the Eastern Mass, and so, you know, it's time for AB to make its name one week at a time, and this is a great. I think we'll be a nightmare for Chelmsford tonight.
All right.
So what do you say, Mark?
Okay, let's play some football.
All right, Mark, here we go. Chelmsford set to receive, and I always get excited about these games as Jack Perry kicks it off. The short kick down to about the 20-yard line as number 44 gets hit big time in the 30-yard line.
Number 44 is Matt Robito. He is their blocking fullback. Doesn't do a lot of running, but he's a big, strong kid, and he opened some holes for Sheridan. And they've got two quarterbacks. They've got their number one, Colby Emmanuel, and then you're going to see their other quarterback, number four, Pat McLaughlin. Emmanuel is sort of like the Michael Vick type quarterback. McLaughlin is more the Drew Bledsoe, a big kid with a big arm.
Emmanuel goes under center, first and 10 for the Lions on their own 31. They reset the tight end. And it gives the tight end to the tailback Sheridan, and maybe a yard gain, stopped big time by the AB defense.
Peter Twombly, right on that play there. It's important to really figure out how they're going to stop this O line at Chelmsford.
And captain number 59, Peter Twombly.
Peter Twombly, the sole captain this year of AB.
Yeah, you saw him line up in the beginning of the game. It was like four or five Chelmsford captains and Peter Twombly, and that kid's got tremendous leadership.
Well, this is not the Woburn O-line. This is a whole, that's a JV. This is the varsity we're playing tonight.
All right, Emmanuel, under center, offset eye, play action as he gets outside, and he's pulled down by Brooks Pullen. Wow, for about a 7-yard loss.
Brooks Pullen would not let go, and Emmanuel is known for his speed and elusiveness, and one of the concerns is that he likes to roll out a lot and he can throw on the run, and Brooks Pullen wouldn't have any of it.
Brooks has some speed as well. So now third and about 17 for the Lions on the 25-yard line as Emmanuel breaks out of the huddle with his team.
And here you got to watch for number two, who split out to the right, Vinny Maniscalco. He's their big-time receiver. Looks like a blitz coming.
There goes Duggan up the middle, and he...
Oh, yeah.
And there it is. Let's see who was that. Peter Trombley with the stop along with Brooks Poulin.
Tim, that is a great defensive stand, and that is so important to establish the tone right from the beginning.
I tell you, as we said, also last week, that this defense is just brand new. So, you know, the techniques we're running on this 4-3, these kids are learning. I think you're going to see improvement every week, Mark.
Billy Jackman back to receive the punt.
AB rushing hard. Looks like, very close to a block, and it's a short kick to about the 44-yard line, maybe 45-yard line of the Lions.
Whoa.
AB with great field position.
Tim, that's a great place to start, a short field. We've got a couple of changes. Brandon Sides got a mild concussion last week. He is not playing. I spoke with his mother, Donna. She hopes he'll be back next week. So we've got a shift here, and Pete Trombley is going to be moving over to guard. And we've got Tom Carter at center, number 72.
Trips right. We've run a quick out. This time, it's Jackman up for about 9 yards. We talked about last week how little we used Jackman last week, Mark.
Well,
it's like a Belichick type of move here.
Exactly.
Call a Maver type of move.
And I spoke with Coach Maver this morning, and he told me precisely that Sweeney can't let Sweeney wear down. They only want Sweeney to run about 15 plays a game. So you're going to see Jackman and James Subner a lot more this game.
Trips right again with Sween Dog and Jackman and Jake Pilecki on the trip, this time up the middle. We run with Matt Brogy for a first down. I love that formation.
Well, Coach Maver was on the field at 9:30 this morning when I talked with him, and he was really concerned that it was windy this morning, and he wants to put the ball in the air tonight against Chelmsford because he feels like he can't do the same thing he did against Woburn, keep it on the ground all the time and be successful.
And it looked like the ref walked off that
ball. Yeah, it looked
ball.
Like there was a little...
Strange, because we got the first down,
yeah.
And he must have been his way of spotting where the ball should be.
It almost looked like half a penalty.
Okay, now wing left. All right, to give us a Sweeney off a cross pop, and he gets tripped up on the edge. Looked like he had a lot of daylight there, Mark.
Yeah, if Sweeney could have bounced out, he probably would have had a touchdown. But number three, Tim Joy, was there to stop it. Tim Joy has already committed to Boston College. He's one of the top football players in Massachusetts. He plays tight end and linebacker and is by far their best player. You got to watch him all the time.
Exciting. At this time, Matt Brogy cuts up the middle for a couple tough yards, but well defended by the Lions.
And once again, Tim Joy was there on the stop. You can't block him with one guy.
They bring up third and nine. Ball on the 28-yard line.
Okay, James Sumner out. Billy Jackman in.
Trips left. Brogy is a single back. Dukes back to pass. Fires, and it's incomplete. Intended for, looks like Jake Pilecki, although
Kyle Sweeney
was in the area.
Yeah, looked like two guys were in the same zone, maybe a little too close to each other. And this is definitely four down territory here, so let's see what kind of play Coach Maver is going to draw up right now. Want to keep this drive going. Got Chelmsford back on their heels right now. Like to see Jake Pilecki get involved here.
Jackman in motion. Dukes back to pass. He's got pressure from the backside. He gets the ball off. It's deep. Four. Oh. Jake Pilecki in and out of the hands. That was a great throw. And Jake had split the seam of two defenders there. Jake was in great position.
Jake ran a great route. A great route, good speed, and just couldn't get his fingertips on that ball. And that ball turns over to Chelmsford right now on the 27-yard line. Oh, that was so close, Tim. So close. And Dukes got rid of the ball just as he got plastered there.
I actually looked towards the end zone, so I didn't see the hit. But
yeah.
Triple I formation. They give the ball to the number five, Nate Carpenter, for about 2 or 3 yards. Chelmsford will run out of that triple I.
Was that Carpenter or Sheridan? I think it was Sheridan.
Was it Sheridan?
Yeah, Sheridan really hits the line hard. You know, the great thing about now having the internet and YouTube is you can Google the guy and you can watch his highlights. And this kid hits the hole really quick. Coach Maber says he is as tough as a Woburn, as good as a Woburn runner, but not as tough.
Second and five, and Sheridan gets loose, but is pushed back. Net about a 3 yard gain, and it'll bring up third and short for the Lions.
Yeah, Tim, I'll correct that. He said that Sheridan is a lot tougher than the guy last week. So it's third and short here.
So you'll see the Lions do this, Mark. They run a lot of different formations, not a lot of plays, but they really have a lot of different formations. They'll run triple I, offset I.
And they'll run a lot of drag routes. We'll talk about that in just a minute.
Sheridan again cracks out to the outside. Or that's. And it is a first down.
Okay, Chelmsford ball right on their 40-yard line. A drag route is where a receiver will go out a few yards and then take like a 90-degree angle. And if you see Tim Joy at tight end, he runs a lot of drag routes, and they will have sometimes two or three receivers doing that at the same time, so Emmanuel can kind of pick a receiver going across the field.
First and 10 for the Lions on their own 40. They give us to Sheridan as he cuts out and back, and this time well covered by the Colonials. The tackle by Akil Willis and company. Looks like
you're gonna see our secondary a lot more involved in this game than they were last week.
Yeah, pretty good spot for the Lions. I didn't think they gained that much, but they're gonna get about 3.5 yards out of that play. Second and six, make it four. So second and six for the Lions.
They've got number 33, Harrington, a tight end, looking right at him here. And he is the nephew of Ray and Kathy Glant.
Blitz. And under pressure and a rollout pass complete by Manuel. It's a first down and more for the Lions as they cross midfield.
Well, that's what we talked about. That's one of the dangers of blitzing. Rabito just snuck out into the flat there, and Emmanuel hit him, and it's another first down for the Lions. You know, we scouted the Lions last week, but they scouted us too, so it's a chess game, and these coaches have coached against each other. Coach Rich and Coach Maber have coached against each other for many years.
Some of the best games I've ever seen.
Absolutely.
At any level. Triple I again. They give us a Sheridan, he cuts out, and this time well covered.
Oh my goodness, nice
stop. Ethan Dukes with the initial stop there, maybe a 2 yard gain. Actually, maybe just a yard gain,
yeah,
second
yeah.
and nine.
Dukes did a great job. There was almost a horse collar there. He got him real high, but it was very effective. See how quickly he gets outside?
It's one of these bounce backs types of thing where he heads towards the tackle and then basically goes parallel to the line of scrimmage to get some distance there. All right, second and nine. Back to pass. It's Emmanuel over the middle for a tight end route intended for number 33.
That's Harrington.
Harrington.
That's the guy we're just talking about.
Right in the bread basket. But incomplete.
Well, we got a break on that one because he was wide open in the seam there, and that ball hit him right in the hands. Third and long.
It's a big play early in this game. Mark, 2:53 to go in the first quarter.
Okay,
third and nine.
You got to watch Maniscalco. He is split out to the left. Oh, they look like some
Manuel back
there.
To pass, and he's in the open field, and he's got some room as he goes all the way down. He looks like he's going to get six, and he does. Wow, what a run.
Well, that's the Michael Vick part of the quarterback we were talking about. This kid can run. You've got to stop Sheridan. You have to stop Emmanuel, and he is their running quarterback, and you can see what kind of speed he has. Now, Coach Rich says he's got five kids with 4-5 speed, and certainly Emmanuel looks to be one of those.
That run started on the near side of the field here and crossed all the way over to the other side of the field and then down for a touchdown. And nobody touched him, Mark.
Yeah. He got down the sideline and he just outran everybody. And you figure third and nine when
Time
the quarterback out. Starts going, you've got a great chance of stopping that play.
Say, it looks like timeout Chelmsford. Look to kick the extra point here. Some confusion.
Now this kicker is only a sophomore. He kicked 31 points after last year as a freshman, but he's a little erratic. So if this game is decided on an extra point, these could be very important plays.
And it is
good.
Boy,
and that's
like
just barely good. That's what we're talking about.
So the Lions strike first with 2:41 to go in the first quarter, 7-0.
Well, Tim, I think it's so important for AB to respond in kind right now and not get the ball back to Chelmsford.
Yeah, we really didn't have our rhythm that first series, Mark. And we tried some things that are really outside of our usual strategy, like that trips right formation with a single back. And let's see what Coach Maber does the second set of downs. Coach Henry Morris with his special teams. Gets them in a huddle and breaks them out of the field. Getting set to receive, and back deep is Billy Jackman and Kyle Sweendog.
Okay, Sweeney. We got two jackrabbits back there. Billy Jackman, 5'7". A little kid with a big heart and as quick as they come. Now they will do an AB kickoff. They'll do a Jack Perry kickoff often, where they kick to maybe the 25-yard line.
This time they kick it away to who caught that? Let's see. It was
exactly,
number
that's exactly
David
what
Jamrock.
They did, yeah. That's exactly what they did. Ball's at the 29-yard line. And let's see if we can get something going here.
Ethan Dukes looks ready to throw. This time it's Jake Blecky on a slant route for a first down.
Perfect pass, perfect catch, perfect route. And Jake's got to feel good about that. I think it's important to, you know, get your first catch and get into the game.
Excellent play.
And that's a great, great timing route.
All right, Pilecki and Jackman split out. This time it's a Delaware sweep. Kyle Sweeney gets covered well, maybe a yard gain. So the Lions definitely are defending against the Delaware.
Well, yeah, you can tell right there in that play the difference between the Woburn Tanners and the Chelmsford Lions.
Also, you could see why we're choosing to run that slant, though. You see that the Lions are in a cover two, and in that particular play.
Right, and that's
going to
keep
route's
that
gonna
open.
Be wide open.
Exactly, that's going to keep it open. So what you have to do is give what the defense gives you, and you have to adjust on the fly.
Lot. Oh, back to pass, Ethan Dukes, and the ball's high, intended for Jake Pilecki. Incomplete, to bring up third, and 10 yards.
Okay, really important to convert on third down here.
Mike Murphy checks in.
All right, third and 10. Big play for AB.
Ball on the AB 42-yard line. It's a fake Delaware pass, and it is complete, but short of the first down to Matt Brody.
Yeah, that's going to be fourth down. Yeah, fourth and six. So Ethan's going to be punting here.
So you can see that the Lions are, you know, they're putting nine men in a box and forcing AB to throw the ball. And, you know, to stretch this field, we're going to have to throw the ball and then do run action instead of
yeah,
play action.
Exactly.
Gotta, pass action.
Got to run to set up the pass here.
Oh, a nice punt. Wow, good cut. And up the field goes number seven, Corey Eberle.
Yeah, Corey Eberle returned a punt 70 yards against Westford last week, and he's another one of those 4-5 kids, another one of those burners. They've got a lot of skilled players in Chelmsford.
Matt Brogy now playing cornerback. Chelmsford first and 10 at their own 37-yard line. This time, they line up in an I. So we've seen three different formations from Chelmsford. They seem to run a formation, a series.
Well, this could be one of those game-defining defensive stops for AB, because you don't want to have Chelmsford put two scores on the board and get that kind of confidence going. But you can see how AB's got to step its game up. It's a very, very different feel to this game from last week, for sure.
No question. Handoff to Sheridan, and he gets some room over the flat, and he goes all the way down to the midfield, or actually to the 40-yard line, and a great run. It was a counter.
And you said it, Tim, what he does, he picks his spot, and then he decides whether he's going to run straight or go wide, and he got about 35 yards on that play.
He really does a very effective using his speed, a bounce run technique that's very tough for us to defend on the edge.
Well, so far this game looks a lot like last year, Tim. You know, last year we went into Woburn, we shut out Woburn 23-0, and then we went to Chelmsford and we couldn't buy a point. We lost 13-0. And my sense was that if we had played that game for two more hours, we wouldn't have scored. And Chelmsford couldn't do too much either. They got a touchdown on a fumble recovery and on a deflected pass. They didn't do a lot either, but we need to find a way to score against this team.
No, but I like these kinds of games, Mark, because you know, here you are with Chelmsford, they have 120 kids on the sideline. You know, we have our 70 or 65, 70 on our side. They have specialized offense, specialized defense, specialized special teams, if you will. And we don't. And
they even have live TV telecasts with instant replay and
still, you know, you can see the possibility of us just rising up to compete with all this.
I love your optimism. let's stop them right here.
Okay, offset eye. Play action. Little dump off to number 44, Matt Rapido, and it's maybe a 3-yard gain. Yeah, big play coming up, Mark.
They could feast on that all night long, and that's an almost an eight-yard gain. They got Rapido just coming out of the flat. He's untouched, and they've got so many weapons that there's a tendency to ignore Rapido when you're looking at guys like Emmanuel and Sheridan who can just, you know, run the table on you any time. Now they're mixing it up very well, running pass. And we've got Carter coming in at linebacker. He did a nice job last week. Got some time at the end of the game, made a few good plays. Coach Maver really thinks a lot of him. He's a junior and he's really up and coming player.
Got Mr. C working on Mikey Duggan on the sideline there. Something. Offset eye to give us to Sheridan.
Yes!
He's met in the backfield.
Whoa.
And there's a flag on the field there.
And I hope that is not encroachment. Whoa, Marcotte just, that's a hold, I think, on Chelmsford. Marcotte just blew the play up.
Nice.
And that's what you need. And they're going to choose not to take the loss, but to take the 10 yards.
That's a big play. Mikey Duggan back in the lineup there after getting his elbow taped up.
I think that was a good call to take the penalty. It would have been about 3rd and 4, but it was really at that point, it was 4-down territory. This way you move them back to a 2nd and 12. And you're back at the 41-yard line.
I agree. AB showing blitz. As Emmanuel backs off into a shotgun. And he rolls right, and wow, does he have room? And he gets up, feels so quick.
Yeah, he is just really, he's just super quick. And picked up about 7 yards on that play.
We are playing
3rd and 5.
We're really giving him a ton of room in the way this works. And of course, with the 4-3, Mark, one of the things is that, you know, it's much harder to cover the flat with those defensive ends.
Absolutely.
Where the 5-2, you'd have the plugger out there.
You're absolutely right. With the 5-2, you've got two pluggers out there. They're in the flat. They can two steps. They're there to cover and contain.
Triple I, 3rd and about 4. They give us a Sheridan in the backfield, and he's taken down.
All right.
By Mikey Duggan.
Mikey Duggan coming back here. Coming back from the trainer's table. Okay, they're going to go for it. There's no question about it. It's 4th and 4, and this is a huge play with 9:16 to go in the second quarter.
Vinny Maniscalco, is that it? He checks in. It's 4th and 3, maybe 4.
Yeah, it's Maniscalco.
And they show trips left. Shotgun.
Probably AB timeout, I would imagine.
And AB didn't like that formation.
Yeah, on that trips, we talk about that drag route. On that trip, they will take all of them and have them all cut toward the middle of the field. And Emmanuel will just pick out the one that he thinks is open. And that's a very effective play. And the thing about Chelmsford is that, you know, even though they have a great runner in Emmanuel and a great runner in Sheridan, they're a very balanced attack. And that's why you just can't key on one player or one scheme.
Yeah, it's amazing just to look at how big this Chancellor program is. And, just an advertisement for everyone out there watching this program, parents, if you're interested in getting your kids involved, it's a terrific sport. The Pop Warner program, always needs more support. The numbers are slightly down, as I understand it. And, you want to see Acton Boxborough football 5 years from now, we need some kids to participate in that great sport.
Okay, big play coming up.
4th and 4. And they line up, trips left still. Here we are. We got man-to-man on the trips on the outside. Emmanuel rolls, and he gets bounced out to the outside, and he gets across to the first down, and he's all the way to a touchdown. I don't know if he stepped out of bounds or not. Wow. Just a lot of Colonials out there.
He just turned the corner like AB defenders were standing still and just watching him. Mikey Duggan had a shot at him, but Emmanuel just had too much speed. So we go into this game talking about Eddie Sheridan and his 5 touchdowns and what a runner he is. And Kobe Emmanuel just steals the show tonight.
And the extra point is blocked. Mark, I thought we had the best defense in the world against that roll-out play. And I'm watching him just with that unbelievable speed go down the sideline.
Yeah, he just gets there in a heartbeat. Well, as we thought, they lost their extra point, so it's 13-0. And let's just hope that that's important in this game. Well, you can see the strength of this Chelmsford team. Any team that could put 54 points on the board against Westford, and Westford coming into the season, preseason, is a pretty good team.
That's very impressive. Although I really could see us starting to sync up and play these kids tough, but that was just, you're right. He does look like a high school version of Michael Vick. All right, let's see where they kick this one, Mark.
This looks like another pooch to the 30.
And it's kicked out of bounds. Nearest Colonial player was David Jamrog again.
Let's see where they spot the ball. And see what kind of field position we get. Well, Timmy, this is a series we've got to come away with points on this series.
You need to respond right now.
Right now, you've got a team in white that's got all the confidence in the world.
And it looks like
we're going to re-kick.
Re-kick. It looks like. Okay.
Okay, that can give us a really good field position. Well, you look at the Chelmsford pursuit right now, and you just wonder if some kind of counterplays, bootlegs might work against that over-aggressive defense.
Well, like we said, they're playing 9 in the box with a cover 2 and back. That's what they typically play against us, but they have some size issue. They really do. Athletic size.
Yeah.
Really.
Yeah, there's size and there's athletic size. That's a very good point. This one's going deep.
They kick it away. Goes to Billy Jackman on the 15-yard line. As he gets outside, cuts up, and well covered by the Lions. As he gets up to about the 25. You can see the speed difference
on the field, can't you? Absolutely, Tim. I'm really impressed with the Chelmsford team speed. A lot of athletes on the field there. Okay, let's see what Dr. Frankenstein has concocted for this series here.
All right, wing left, nine in the box for the Lions again. And it's a Delaware with Kyle Sweeney cutting back up the field for a first down run. And there's your cutback there, Mark.
All right, that's more like it. And we've got to get Swing Dog out in the open air. And we just got to make that first block and let Sweeney do the rest of it. This Chelmsford secondary did not distinguish itself against Westford last week, and that really is their Achilles heel.
And a 35 power by Kyle, and he takes the subway to about a 4-yard gain, maybe 5-yard gain, all the way up to the 40-yard line.
That's a good 39. Gain on first. Well, they didn't give him much. They only gave him about 3.5 yards in that play.
Second and 6 for the Colonials.
Okay, let's
They're going back to basics,
we
Mark.
We've got to get a little bounce in our step now, okay?
Jake Pilecki splits out wide along with Kyle Sweeney. This time it's to Jake Pilecki over the middle, and a great catch in traffic for a first down and more.
Hands. What a great catch.
Great throw, too.
I want to tell you, Ocho Cinco could learn a little bit from that catch.
Very nice.
Well, we said right from the beginning that Jake was going to be a big factor this year in the DCL. There's a blitz.
Great perfect play against the blitz. We got a good block on the outside as Billy Jackman goes up to the 36-yard line for another first down.
All right, and Jake Pilecki, after making that great reception, springs a block that just lets Billy Jackman go straight down the field. Nice block by Jake.
Wing left, it's Delaware again, and Kyle cuts up for another 5-6 yards. Hey, back to basics, we're doing
great.
It right.
That's great, and you can feel the pace of the game changing. It was a little lethargic at the beginning. Now you can feel that there's some rhythm to the AB offense.
I also think some confidence. You know, we have a great offensive line, and I think these kids are starting to feel that they can play with the vaulted Lions here.
6:35 to go in the second quarter.
Back to pass is Ethan Dukes, and it's complete.
Right on the sideline. And that's Jake again. That's his third reception tonight. And Coach Mavers, true to his word, he said he was going to open it up tonight.
And that's about an 8-yard gain, or 6-yard gain, about 3rd and 2. This time we line up in a flex.
How about Matt Marcotte? Nope. Whoa.
And it's
he might have got that first down with that little pinwheel.
Tough kid. First down Colonials.
I think he got a good spot. Yes, absolutely. Another first down.
I don't think we even needed a good spot there, Mark. I think that was just the leap to freedom. First down there.
That was like Willie the Whale. You know, like the whale that leapt over.
Look at that. Flex again on 1st and 10.
Whoa.
Little movement there. We got away with it. It's Kyle. Bounces around for about a 5 or 6 yard gain and no flags on the field.
Oh, thank you. I was looking for a yellow flag on that field, even if it was a late flag, because Kyle left just a little bit early on that play. And now they're keeping their players fresh. They're moving people in and out.
5:20 to go in the first half. And the snap was just dropped there and recovered by Ethan Dukes. He just snuck it up there. So tough loss of down there, Mark, in a pivotal area. So it brings up 3rd and about 6, a long 6.
Yeah, this is could definitely be a passing down here.
2-down territory, 4:43 to go and counting in the first half, 13-0. Lions trips right. with Matt Brogy in the backfield. Ethan Dukes back to pass. He throws a corner route, and it's intercepted by the Lions. Ball just a little short.
Yeah, the ball just hung up a little too long, allowed the defender to get right in front of Jake and make the interception. So, well, good news, bad news. Good news is we moved the ball, we got some rhythm to the offense. Bad news is we couldn't put it in the end zone. And it's 13-0 with 4:26 to go, deep in Chelmsford territory. A great place, great spot for a turnover, wouldn't you say?
I'd say so. But, you know, I think the other takeaway from that drive is that we should have some confidence. We can move the ball against these kids, see if we can do the same on defense now, you know, respond.
Matt
and
Duggan,
a good play.
Matt
there you go.
Duggan.
Mikey Duggan taking Sheridan around for a little spin wheel.
Very nice play. I always call him Matty Duggan. Oh, so used to Matty Duggan.
No gain like that.
They're deep in their territory. If we can hold them on the next two plays, we've got a good opportunity to come in, get a touchdown, go in 13-7, and you're right back in the game. And then that missed extra point becomes so important.
Trips left.
Oh, we got some movement there. Let's see what we got there. Yeah, I like that. I like the way he does that little do-si-do thing. Yeah.
Very nice. That'll bring up third down. And
well, actually, still second down.
Oh, second down and about 12 or 13 here, Mark. It ball's on the, but the 2 yard line, let's
right.
say.
About the two and a half yard line. So this becomes dangerous territory for the Lions.
Triple I for the Lions. Back to passes Emmanuel as he gets out in the flat. Throws it deep and well covered, double covered by the Colonials. The ball was intended for number 83.
Yeah, Akil Willis and Billy Jackman on the coverage, but that surprised me a little bit. You know, protecting a 13-0 lead to take that kind of chance. Chelmsford is really going for broke in this game. Not playing it close to the vest at all. Well,
all right, 3:20 to go in the first half.
Do you blitz in the end zone here?
I don't think so, Mark. I think with the speed they have, you don't want a break situation. But I do think, you know, if you can stop them here, one down, contain the play inside 13 yards, you get the ball back with about 3 minutes to go, and I think that's all you can ask for this time in this particular situation. So. I would say we're not going to blitz.
Well, I'm going to say that AB has taken over the momentum of this game, and we have another half to play too. So
I take that back, though. A middle linebacker blitz or something like that really doesn't risk us too much. I just don't. I think that the contain is going to remain intact, and so you might see Mikey Duggan go.
And also, if they don't complete a pass here, they're not going to have much room to punt.
There he goes, it's Mikey.
Oh, his encroachment.
Oh.
That takes it out 5 yards.
Well, they haven't called it yet, but it is, yep.
Yeah, encroachment. Mikey just made it just a touch. That's all you need is just a touch for that 5 yard penalty. But that was the play call. You called it middle linebacker blitz. Another timeout. Now it's Chelmsford.
Chess game is here, as it always
Absolutely.
Is between these two teams.
Well, if you look at the rest of the DCL, Lincoln Sudbury didn't do anything to change their preseason reputation. They beat Tewksbury 28-0, and from what I'm told, it wasn't even that close. So Lincoln Sudbury is loaded this year, but as we've said every season, playing teams like Chelmsford before the DCL season starts is just invaluable experience.
No question. This is the competition you want. You can learn a lot about your football team, and you need to learn it early. So, 3:20 to go, 3rd and 7, maybe 3rd and 8, actually. The Colonials starting to gel on both sides of the ball. Still have a chance to get the ball back with a big defensive stand here. Back to passes to Manuel, and he gets cut down. I don't know
short.
About the first
he is
down.
Short. He's short. He is short of the first down. He's at least a yard short of the first down.
And the ref is saying, fourth down. All right.
Okay,
so they held
play.
Him.
Great play.
The Colonials come up big with 3 minutes to go in the first half. They get a chance to strike.
I got plenty of time. Don't have to do anything extraordinary. There's almost 3 minutes to go. And this punter really takes time. He's a slow punter. It takes a while to get that punt off. That can be good and bad.
Jake Plecky on a pretty good rush there. And Billy Jackman,
oh, what a roll.
Let it roll. They go across midfield to about the 47-yard line. 1st and 10, Colonials with 2:22 to go in the first half.
All right, the key here is to see if we can just build on what we've started in the last series. We're moving the ball down the field. We're finding ways to eat into that Chelmsford defense, to find the soft spots in the defense. Jake Pilecki has come up big with two really nice catches.
A lot of resetting going on in a Colonial defense, double wing.
Okay, Kyle in
motion. Swing dog, and it's Dukes on a keeper around the end. And the speed of the Lions pull him down after about a 3-yard gain.
Yeah, that was Harrington on the stop there.
2:08.
Yeah, Harrington on the stop. He's got a lot of speed, but that's what you have to do. You have to mix up these plays, Tim.
Ethan Dukes, a little bit of a equipment repair on the end of the field. He's getting a play from Coach Maver.
All right.
Second
good,
and about
good game.
7. Wow, some big hits going on as Kyle Sweeney bounces his way up for about an 8-9 yard gain and bring up 3rd and 1.
Yeah, well, Harrington helped him out there because Harrington's tackle pulled Sweeney ahead about 4 yards. So it's 3rd and 2 right now, 3rd and a long 2.
1:16 to go.
Oh, boy.
Big stop by the Lions as they snuffed out that middle run and it'll bring up 4th down.
Okay, decision time here. 1:04 to go. You're down 13-0. If you don't make it, you give Chelmsford the ball on the 45-yard line. I don't see any punting team coming in here.
Clock spinning down to 49
okay,
seconds.
Okay, they're going to talk about it. 49 seconds to go. Timeout. I don't see a punt here, Tim. If you're going to go for it, you go for it. If you're up 13-0, you punt. If you're down 13-0, it's 4th and make it. All right, little confusion here. Let's get our get everyone in. You've got Poulin and Marcotte out. You got your two big strong guys coming out, and you got your speed people coming in.
Fourth and about three, 49 seconds to go in the first half. The Lions showing all out blitz.
Oh, timeout? Was that a timeout just before the snap? Wow.
Wow.
Boy, I tell you, that reminds me of like a batter in baseball calling timeout just as the pitcher is in the middle of his delivery. And that's strange because they were blitzing.
They look like, the Lions look like that was well defended. We were lined up and, you know, with two wideouts. I thought they were going to send the whole team, but they really had, you know, I thought it looked like it was well defended.
It could be like their version of watching a play come in at a basketball game to see how the alignment is and how they're going to set up and then call a timeout. As you say, it's a chess match. Every moment you're adjusting to what the other team is doing and what the other coach is doing.
Lots of confusion.
Oh, that could be encroachment there. I thought I saw encroachment.
Jake Pilecki going in motion out of the slot.
Yeah, no, it's against AB.
Okay, now we're going to punt.
Yeah, we have to punt now. It's unfortunate, Tim. But you know, we're down 13 to nothing, but I've seen a lot of good things lately.
And, you know, we really could be up 21-13. I mean, we were just a few plays away here situationally in this football game, even though we've been, you know, certainly physically on our heels a notch in this first half, I'd say. But from a speed point of view and so on. But we had the opportunities, Mark, in this first half to be opportunistically in the lead.
Yeah, and I think the line is coming together. And as always, we've always been one of the best conditioned teams around. So we'll see what happens in the second half, and we'll see who wears down more. Chelmsford just looks bigger. They look bigger, more athletic, just looking at them. They look like almost like a college team.
They really do.
Like a D3 college team.
An end over end kick.
Oh, I think we might have it. Oh!
I think it is AB football. Let's see where the rest.
Wouldn't that be a break? Wouldn't that be a break here? No. No excitement, no jumping up and down. Chelmsford recovered. But that was.
I think the only issue was we were out of bounds when we recovered it. Otherwise, Mark, I think we had that ball. So 38 seconds to go.
Well, I think Coach Rich will have a few words with his punt returner on that play. That could have been disastrous for the Lions. Well, I wouldn't be surprised if they just tried to air it out. Let's see if the other quarterback is in. No, Emmanuel is still in. But once again, watch out for number two, Vinny Mascalco.
Who's split out wide to the far side of the field, yeah.
And he's a burner.
And it's Sheridan getting on the wide side of the field. Wow, what speed as he gets a 20-yard gain with 29 seconds to go in the first half.
Yeah, he just ran by a couple of defenders, just ran by Whittier. Duggan was able to get him. They're in a hurry up offense here.
Manuel rolling out. and it's intercepted by Akil Willis.
All right.
That's his second interception of the season. 13 and a half seconds to go. I'm seeing some life in the blue and gold here. This game is far from over.
Big crowd tonight.
Yeah, this is always a big take.
Double wing. Dukes rolls out. And he'll get maybe a yard or two.
Whoa.
As he rolls towards the Chelmsford bench.
I tell you, he said hello to a few Chelmsford parents there, but he just popped right up. I like that, Ethan. He just popped right up and went right to the bench for the next play. This was the score last year, 13 to nothing. That was the final last year.
Double wing, again. Sweeney on a little fly pattern as he cuts up across midfield for a first down. Half a second to go if that clock is accurate.
Half a second, that's right. Well, it's 46 yard line.
And Ethan's got a strong arm.
He can put that ball in the five-yard line or so, I would say, from there. Get a couple of tips, a lucky break. It's certainly worth the shot with a half a second to go. And they called a timeout. It wasn't a first down timeout. If it was a first down timeout, they would immediately start the clock. So they will get the playoff.
A lot of strategy this first half, Mark.
Boy, it really is.
All right. Colonials line up. And they show slot right with Jackman just off the tackle. Ethan Dukes back to pass. He's got time. Wiggs, he got his arm hit at the last minute, and it's knocked down by the Lions, and they'll go into the half with the Lions up 13-0.
All right, there's still hope here. We got two quarters to play, 13-0, and you've got two Colby Emmanuel runs. That kid is just as quick as can be, and but I think we're getting our feet under us here.
Yeah, I really could see Coach Maver, the first words out of his mouth when he gets his kids in the locker room and say, we can play with these guys. You come into the game, you're looking at this team that's ranked and everything else, you got the jitters out of you now, we can play with it. Let's go back out there and play blue and gold football and see where it takes us. That's what he's gonna say.
I tell you, Tim, I'm gonna come back for the second half.
All right, we'll see you in a couple of minutes. All right, here we go, Mark. Colonial set to receive with Billy Jackman and Kyle Sweeney. Back deep, and here we go, and they kick it away.
That's gonna be out of, no. It's
Jackman
not be
takes
out of
it on his 8-yard line and goes up the sideline. And the Lions meet him at the 20. First stop there, first and 10 Colonials.
Okay, the key here, Tim, is no panic, lots of time. Go down the field, work your offense, and just have confidence in your game.
Little spring in the step of the Colonials as they get up to the line. I like the energy.
And you got James Sumner.
Double wing. And they run a nice big dive up the middle with Matt Brogy, looks like. Is that Brogy? Yes.
Yeah, and he was popped by Vinny's brother there, James Maniscalco. But a good first down gain, 6 yards. I think Kenny Mayer is stepping it up too. The Velvet Voices, I think he had a little 5-hour energy drink during halftime.
Second and a long three. This time it is a fly with Kyle Sweeney as he cuts up for first down.
All right.
I saw Kenny over the half and he was psyched.
Kenny's ready. We're all ready for a good second half here. You know, you get punched in the face a couple of times. You get off the canvas and you say, okay, I got something too. Okay, they're looking good. They're looking good. They're looking confident.
All right, little 35 powers. Kyle Sweeney cuts up for close to first down yards again.
Okay, this brings up a really interesting scenario here. They've only got about a yard and a half to go for first down. So they've got a lot of options here on second down to kind of open up the playbook.
I wing right formation. And right up the middle is Kyle Sweeney as he cuts up for first down and more all the way up to midfield.
I sense a renewed sense of purpose here. This is purposeful football.
We changed some of our blocking assignments. There's some cross blocking going on up there, Mark. We're getting some movement.
Are we talking about halftime adjustments here?
I think, you know, Coach Maver's always had a good feel for that. All right. On the 49. Little bobble on the ball, but Shane Sumner gathers it in for another 6-yard run. We're getting a push off the line.
I tell you, this team's like a bunch of piranhas now. Little piranhas. They're just, you know, chucking off 5-6 yards each play. They're just eating flesh right now.
I just like the energy. The coaches are jumping around. Second and four. Fake fly and a dive up the middle is Brogy's. Pounds up
he's
for close
it.
To a first
he's
down.
Got, he's got that first down. That looks like it's good by about a half a yard. But
see where they spot it. That's a red
spot. Bad spot.
Third and one.
I would have given them another yard there.
Lots of personnel changes here. As Matt Marcotte and Brooks Pullen check in, let's see if they line up in a flex. And they do.
No problem at all. First and 10, do it again on the 39-yard line of the Lions.
Did you see?
7:35 to go.
You see Swing Dog with that burst of speed? He took like two steps and then all of a sudden he shifts into like ninth gear. And that's in the power run, he does that. You know, it's just really, it's something to see.
Okay, Pullen and Marcotte. Come out. Almost like you have your speed unit and your power unit. And the speed unit is in right now with James Sumner.
There's Sweeney around the edge. Wow, he got around there fast. They're starting to spread the Lions out.
The feeling right now of momentum changing is palpable. You can just feel it in the air, you feel it on the field. And AB knows it. They know that they're dominating right now on the line.
Nothing fancy here. Second and four. James Sumner this time.
He got blown up.
Run blitz.
Yeah. Okay, minor setback. They just have to convert a 3rd and 7.
All right, 3rd and 7, the ball on the 37-yard line. Flex. Kyle Sweeney up the middle for 3 or 4 back.
Okay, going to bring up a very interesting play call here on about 4th and they're going to give them a tough spot here. It's still 4th and 5.
There's a Lion
and
down.
Maniscalco is down. He's hurting.
It looks like the Colonials are going to go for it here, but Mr. C will head out to the field to assist the Lions staff. With 5:47 to go in the third quarter, the Colonials showing some life here. It's a big, big play right here, Mark.
It really is, because with what they've been doing and how they've dominated, to not be able to convert on this fourth down play is going to take a lot of wind out of their sails right now. They know that they can play with this Chelmsford team. They just have to get a couple of breaks. They have to be able to convert. And it's kind of a restless quiet right now on the field as Mr. C tends to the, I think it's number 9. And he's getting up on his feet. Yeah, that is Jake Maniscalco. Oh, I'm sorry. That's number 8. That's Cody Nazzaro.
And temperature's falling off.
Looks like he got an ankle injury there.
Temperature's falling off big time here, Mark.
Yeah, I think it's going to be in the 40s by the time we're done with this game.
Wow.
But this is football weather. You know, you feel alive. This is what it's supposed to be like.
Absolutely. All right, slot right. 4th and 5. Back to pass, Ethan Dukes. Double clutches and overthrown.
The question as to whether Jake might have been held up a little bit.
And that's what he's saying to the ref.
Yeah. Ethan was throwing to where he thought Pelecki would be, but...
And he did throw the ball. I mean, it's a post pattern, and I think Jake was held right as he was beginning to slant towards the post. Unfortunate. All right, it'll be a turnover and downs as Elias take over 1st and 10. On their 33-yard line.
Well, now it's going to be really important to see how AB responds to this, because this can go both ways, either way here, where the defense steps up. Dukes and Mike Duggan and Jake Pelecki was just
Mike Murphy
chasing them all over the place.
Very nicely done. All right, 2nd and 11 for the Lions. Great defensive play there.
We always talk about the offense helping the defense here. And maybe there's some life in both ends of the... There's a blitz!
Back to passes, Mancuso. Emmanuel, I should say.
Oh! No, it's no good. I thought he had it. That was...
Well, you could see Akil Willis playing up tight on that corner coverage.
That
and you wondered... whether or not that was going to set up a one-on-one, and they did. They ran a tear, and we had some help rotating into that play as well. Interesting.
Wow, and that pass was a rainbow pass, but that wound up right in Tim Joy's breadbasket. And you can see why this kid has been recruited by BC. He's a big, strong linebacker kid who can... Go out and burn it too.
6'2", 215 pounds. All right, back to pass Emmanuel as he rolls in the middle. And wow, look at the speed. All the way down to across midfield. Michael Vick in high school.
He is the difference in this game. There's no question about it. Three plays. the difference in this game. This play, giving him a first down in midfield, two touchdown runs, and it's almost like you can't stretch the field enough defensively to stop him. You just can't get an angle on him. That was a big play, Tim.
That was huge.
That was a huge play with only 4:24 left in the third quarter.
We need a turnover.
That's just what I was thinking. You were reading my mind. We need a turnover.
Well, there's a blitz with Mikey Duggan at the middle.
Oh, he got him.
And he tripped
up. He got him. Mikey Duggan. Beautiful. And that was an ankle.
Matt Marcotte as well on that. In fact, Matt was there. Mikey slanted off Matt. They just worked in tandem there to take the Lions Sheridan down.
Nice ankle tackle. And, you know, as we said at halftime, Tim, Sheridan isn't the guy that's hurting us. He was the guy that came in. He's the runner. He's got five touchdowns the last game. We're expecting him to run all over us, and he really hasn't done much of anything.
All right, offset eye, another blitz. Back to pass to Emmanuel as he throws the fly route down the sidelines, and it's caught.
That's the guy
wow.
we talked about. That's Vinny.
And we are well covered. We had three Colonials around him, but he really just leaped up and played on the ball.
Also, that ball spent a lot of time in the air. I mean, that ball was not a frozen rope. That ball was a wounded duck. And good catch by Maniscalco.
All right, strong right formation for the Lions. And it's Sheridan as he goes backside to the weak side and gets up for about 5 or 6 yards. And the Lions starting to regain some of the momentum in this game.
Absolutely. And we haven't seen McLaughlin at all. It's been Kobe Emmanuel right from the start. Last week against Westford, McLaughlin started the second half. In fact, Chelmsford didn't come out for the start of the second half. They came out 10 minutes late. They were given a 15-yard unsportsmanlike penalty, and then McLaughlin throws a 69-yard touchdown pass on the first play of the second half.
Wow. Blitz. And
good
it
stop.
Worked
good
right
stop.
In. We blitzed that backside hole. Sheridan stops. It'll bring up fourth down.
Okay, it's third and four.
Third and four.
Peter Trombley's having a great game. Really great game on both sides of the ball.
He's so solid, that kid.
Well, Kenny Mayer calls it third and three, so it's going to be third and three.
Triple I. Give us to Sheridan, the tailback. A lot of carries, and Nikhil Willis gets a piece of him, and Billy Jackman, but looks like that'll be first down.
That's a first down. Actually.
Well, no.
No, it's I'm looking at the... It's really hard to get a handle on the angle here. It's all that they're going to take a measurement, and it's going to be very, very close. I thought he had the first down easily.
It's two down territory here. That's for sure.
Yeah, it looks like a first down.
First down.
First down. First and 10. And Chelmsford is eating clock here. There's about just over a minute to go in the third quarter.
All All right, first and 10 on the 15. The Colonials marching again. Lions marching again against the Colonials. I formation. This time a fullback dive and nothing there as the Colonials come up strong.
And you had a nice fake by Emmanuel, and nobody bought that. Brooks pulling in on that, Marcotte. And Mikey Duggan. This is good. This is looks like it's Custer's last stand, Tim, with almost clock ticking down to the end of the third quarter.
Well, you got to think Emmanuel's going to take the ball at this play. That fullback dive play is a setup for a keeper.
Yeah, exactly. Because that if he had kept the ball, he might have gone in for a touchdown because he was wide open. There wasn't anyone within 3 yards of him, and with his speed, he had the angle to the end zone. Timeout with 14 seconds to go. Trombley coming in, giving the defensive signals.
Wow, look at this formation. Lions break out. Offset eye. Sheridan out in the flat. And he cuts back.
Nothing doing. Great coverage.
Almost had him for a loss.
Yeah. Ethan Dukes got out there. And Peter Cannell. Really good coverage to the side. They had a good angle on that play. And we're going to the fourth quarter here. 13-0. And Chelmsford's knocking on the door again.
We're playing them tough, Mark. I tell you, after we got our nerves settled out of that first quarter, I think, you know, we've really played them like I expected us to play them.
Well,
really,
the fact is,
take a couple of punches and play tough and play maybe a little bit of elastic defense, but stay tough. And I think that's how we've been playing since then.
Yeah, exactly. It's been 0-0 for a long time. No one scored. And
this is why you play a team like this. You can see the learning that's going on, the confidence that's building in our team. Even in facing, you know, 13 points down, we're beginning to understand, you know, the kind of high level you need to play at to beat some of the better teams in the Eastern Mass football.
Well, Coach Maver said that, you know, the work ethic of this team is improving. You know, back in August, he had some concerns about it, and it's improving week to week. And, you know, we don't start that DCL schedule for a few weeks. And hopefully by that time, this team is going to be well seasoned and ready to go against the likes of Lincoln, Sudbury, and Westbury. In the meantime, we've got some work to do here with a 3rd and 4.
Going Lions
back into
going
that trips.
Yeah. All right, it's a fullback dive and taken down by Jake Plecky and company.
Okay, the question is, are they going to try a field goal? It wouldn't be a long field goal. It would give them a 16-0 lead, which is still a two-score game, but that would require two-point conversions.
My opinion, because it's still a two-score game, I think you got to go for it here.
Yeah, and I'm not sure how much confidence they have in their kicker and their ability to get that kickoff successfully.
Manuel on the shotgun. You know, out of that population of football players, you can't find a field goal kicker. I'm not sure what's going on.
That's right.
But.
Well, he made one. He's only a sophomore. He made one field goal last year, but. Well, they had Emmanuel set up in the Wildcat. And, you know, it's almost like you just give it to him and just say, run and get the first down. And somehow he finds a way to do it.
I think his average yards per carry this game has to be 10, 11, 12.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
It's like equivalent to what Kyle Sweeney's was last week.
Once again, that chess game you're talking about is probably taking place right now, where Coach Rich understands that we may be just keying on Emmanuel. Maybe he's going to do something that's going to surprise us, and then maybe we think what they think, and we decide to back off Emmanuel.
Well, look at that. They're going to kick a field goal now.
Aha! This is a very interesting call.
I wouldn't do it. You're still two scores. Get to a three-score gain, that's one thing. So here we go. Snap is up, and it is.
Oh, it's
no
good. Okay.
All right. So the angel of Leary Field shows up again.
The Leprechauns. Well, that was an ill-advised decision based on their kicking game that we've seen so far. And like you said, that still keeps it a two-possession game. So we got a little life. Breathed a little life, dodged a bullet, and now we're on the offense.
10-13 to go in the game. First and 10, Colonials on the 30. Little counter up the middle, and well-disciplined play.
Well, the problem is that play just did not develop the way that it could have. James Sumner was just one step short on that. Took a little while to develop, and that allowed the Lion defender to stop that.
Corey Everly with the tackle. Second and 10. Back to pass is Ethan Dukes, and the ball is batted down. Lucky that was a ruled an incomplete pass. Yeah, could have been a little bit backwards there.
It was very close. It was right on the plane, as they say. Third and 11, and we're in a hole very quickly. Now you have to look for some pass receiving threat other than Jake Pilecki.
Well, you got Billy Jackman in the slot there. Back.
Good
the
time.
Pass.
Good time.
There's
yes!
Jackman. And it is.
Oh no!
Oh,
wait
it looked
a
like
minute.
He caught the ball and got pushed out there.
He got pushed out. Oh, that ball was right. Beautiful pass by Dukes to Billy Jackman, and I thought they were going to give him the reception on that.
For sure he had 1 foot. It looked like from here anyhow, 1 foot in bounds.
I want to go down and throw the flag on the field and get a replay.
Oh, that's a tough call.
Well, the official was right there. It was right on the play, but.
Good kick.
But tough bounce, okay. Good coverage by Billy Jackman. This is looking more and more like a replay of last year's game in Chelmsford, Tim. 13-0 Lions.
Very much.
And now we have gone seven quarters without a point against Chelmsford.
That's an astute observation there, Mr. Stat. Dude there. Seven quarters, huh?
Seven quarters.
Hopefully by the time everybody listens to this broadcast, the Red Sox have been starting to play some better ball out there.
If they don't win tonight, they're in big trouble. There's a blitz. Oh, just overran it. Billy Jackman just.
That's about an 8 or 9 yard gain.
Was that Marcotte?
Marcotte.
Yeah, just overran that blitz.
Eight
8:56 to go in the game. Clock starting to become a factor.
Yeah, well, here's the part of the game where your defense is going to take chances, and that can certainly open things up for Chelmsford for a long play and another score. But you got to, you know, high risk, high reward now. That's the only way you can play.
All right, the pitch to Sheridan. He cuts out on the flat, and it looks like he's close to a first down.
Yeah, there was a nice cutout block there. Thought that they might have had him behind the line of scrimmage, but he just split the two defenders. And let's see where they spot the ball. Looks like it may still be a third down now. Third and a half a yard. Chelmsford certainly taking their time. It's in their interest to kind of just eat the clock here. 7:50 to go. Looks like a sneak.
And, wow. Whoa. Explosion up the middle.
Boy, he almost broke that on a quarterback sneak there. I don't understand how he got from point A to point B.
I didn't see that. That kid is quick. That's about the most explosive QB sneak I've ever seen, I think. You know. Pass to the corner, looking good, and yes, the Chelmsford Lions.
Yeah, that was pretty predictable. It was just one-on-one coverage with Akil Willis, and this kid's a burner. And Colby Emmanuel, you know,
he threw a phenomenal pass.
Absolutely, for somebody who is considered to be a running quarterback and not their passing quarterback, that ball was right on the money.
It's a good call. The Lions go up 19-0 with 7 to go, lining up for the extra point kick. And, you know, at this point in the game, we're taking a lot of defensive risk. We need to blitz. We need
exactly.
to disrupt. And that's really what happens. But you really have to do it. That's the only choice you have in this point of the game.
Going for two here.
And no good. Pass intended for Sheridan on a drag route. So, with 7 minutes to go in the game, the Lions really put this game securely in hand, 19-0.
Well, we could get two touchdowns, two conversions, and a 50-yard field goal at the buzzer to tie the game up here.
That's what you got to do. You got to gamble. I didn't expect Emmanuel to throw that kind of ball based on the scouting report. They said he could throw the ball, you know, short to medium and run.
Right.
That
exactly.
was an excellent pass.
That was perfect pass. And Akil Willis had no help. He was out there on an island against their top pass receiver. Okay, looks like the Pooch is coming up here.
And Kyle Sweeney takes it. It gets up to the 35-yard line, first and 10 Colonials.
And you can see they've got the team speed there on special teams not to let Kyle get to the outside. Okay, really important to get a score here before the end of the game. Okay, timeout AB. Okay, just wondering what that what that timeout was all about. Tough to burn a timeout with 7 minutes to go, but
a little bit of a personnel adjustment there.
A little bit of personnel confusion.
Well, okay. Ethan Dukes away with.
He did well.
He really did.
He did well to avoid that sack. Okay, you got James Sumner split out right. Well, they're coming. They're
Dukes
coming
back
now.
Back to pass, all out blitz, and it's a screen to Brogy as he gets up the middle for about a 4 or 5 yard gain. And Ethan Dukes,
how did Ethan Dukes get that pass off? You have a freight train coming at you, and he just stood right in there and got that pass off at the very last split second. That's one thing that I just don't understand about quarterbacks. How can they just stand in there knowing that they're going to get belted and not flinch?
Really is tremendous guts. Quarterback
yes.
sneak.
That's it. He's got a first down. All right, let's get a little hurry up offense going here, guys.
Delaware with Sween Dog as he cuts up and out for about five or six yards. Nice move.
Nice gain. Nice cut by Sweeney. I'll tell you, I've been very impressed with Joy, but I've also been impressed with Harrington, number 33. He's had a very good game.
I have as well. I think Harrington's really played very well. Kyle Sweeney running hard.
First down. Let's stop that clock with 5:10 to go. No, we've got to stop that clock now. 5:07 to go.
Kid's got a lot of heart, Mark.
He does. He's a tough kid. Yeah. Very tough kid. I was so
impressed.
Look at
that scoreboard, 19-0. He's running just as hard as any run he's had all season. Up, down. Really a very, just a tremendous quality kid. All right, trips right. First and 10. It's a toss on the weak side to Kyle. Sween Dog Sweeney, he backs up. He gets some room. Little backside block. No, just gets caught.
Ethan was ready. He was ready to block somebody, but he just couldn't find anyone to block. Well, they're competing, Tim. They're competing right down to the last minute.
And a little pass out to the flat for maybe a yard, depending on the spot.
Okay, that's going to stop the clock. It's going to be a third and little over 10 yards to go.
Kyle Sweeney with the reception. Bring up third and 11.
Oh, you know, Chumster is going to be coming on this. Let's see what kind of protection Dukes can get. Another timeout, AB. And I think right now, Tim, the idea is not to win the game. The idea is to do some teaching, do some talking, and help Ethan Dukes figure out the offense. try to prepare for some point in the future during the season and play some situational football here.
I agree, Mark. It's really all about situational football. Go out and execute a play, one play at a time. Back to pass, Ethan Dukes has time. Throws long over the middle, intended for Jake Plecky, who had triple coverage.
Yeah, they're basically in a prevent at this point. Fourth down, fourth and 11. No reason not to go for it at this point. Oh, well, Ethan, you know, a quarterback sneak now. Fourth and 11 might trip them up a little bit.
The Lions still playing nine in a box, though. All out blitz. Picked up nicely by Matt Brogy.
Oh.
And he still gets the ball off. Ethan Dukes is showing some toughness.
Had a gun there.
Incomplete. And the Lions will take over and downs. But
yeah, Ethan's a tough, tough kid. Okay, the Lions at this point looking basically just to run it out. Got some new uniforms on both sides of the field here.
Colonial fans would also like to remind you next Saturday, the cheering and football Colonials will be holding their annual car wash fundraising event. Bring your cars, trucks, boats, whatever could use a good cleaning for the community of building.
Well, they still have Kobe Emmanuel in there at quarterback.
We hope to see you all here next Saturday.
Wow, that's something. The toss to Sheridan. And he gets taken down in a flat. Nicely done.
Well, there's no second and third team offense coming here at 19 to nothing with 3:43. I think Coach Rich realizes he's played against Coach Maver too many times to take any chances at all. There have been some strange endings to these Acton-Boxborough-Chelmsford games.
Sure has.
And most of them have gone in favor of AB.
Tackle last time by Akash Shah. Playing outside linebacker there. 3:14 to go.
Good pursuit. Good
Excellent.
Pursuit.
Oh, oh, he escapes. Goes down the sideline. Another quick back for the Lions. Number 25, Connor Brimley, I think.
Yeah, and Connor Brimley is really a defensive back. He had a great game against Westford. He had two interceptions and a fumble recovery. And now he's getting a chance to be on the other side of the field. Unfortunately, Connor Brimley is just a junior. He's got another year.
On the 39-yard
line, of the Colonials for Jennifer
High School.
A keeper by Emmanuel.
Oh, good pursuit.
No, it wasn't.
Good pursuit, okay. Carter on the stop. Nice play by Carter. And he's coming out right now. I've been impressed with Thomas Carter's play. I mean, I agree with Coach Maver. He really is a player.
Second and eight for the Lions. Marching down the field again.
There's Brimley again.
Brimley showing again good speed, nine yards.
Tim, it must be the last of the eighth at Fenway because the band is playing Sweet Caroline right now. Okay, we're down to 110 to go. And we've got a new quarterback, finally. McLaughlin is finally in the game.
Wow, and a burst of speed along the outside.
That's it.
It's touchdown Lions.
Yeah, it's Brent Brindley again. He is the next running back for Chelmsford. A late touchdown.
And I'm not sure that Coach Maver's going to appreciate the score with the Lions making most of that drive with their first TMO.
Yeah.
Going down the field,
the last play, they had the second team quarterback in. Now they're going to try to kick an extra point, something they've had a little trouble doing. This, it's about the only thing that they've had a problem with this game.
And the kick is up and it is good.
All right, 26-0.
26-0 with 49 seconds to go in a game. Good. How you doing, Johnny?
Well, we talk about, you know, we use all the cliches, learning experience, character building. Sometimes you can't put lipstick on a pig, you know? You got to call it what it is. And Chelmsford tonight was clearly the better team, Tim.
No question. I think really it was tonight about speed. And, you know, you can only cover so many fast players on the field. And I think we accounted for Sheridan very nicely in the game.
Yeah, we did.
I'm sure as you sit down and game plan from a defensive point of view, you know, you can account for either Sheridan or Emmanuel, but you probably can't account for both very easily with the personnel you have. And I think that really was the problem. So we said, okay, we're going to stop Sheridan, and Emmanuel effectively beat you tonight.
That's
right. I think
that's
really the story.
And also with his arm too.
But I think it's, character building is a good term, but I think more importantly, it's just the way we go about preparing for the DCL, which is to play as tough a schedule as we can possibly get our hands on, so that when we get into the DCL, you know, the game slows down enough for us to compete.
That's exactly right. And one of these games that we're going to be playing is Marshfield, which is every bit as good as Chelmsford. Marshfield is a very tough team.
They always have been. It's always a well-coached, big-time football town, tradition.
Well, they went into Catholic Memorial and they beat them 24-0 in the first week.
Wow.
And that was a bit of a surprise.
What a nice run by James Sumner for a first down.
All right, let's do that again, James. Let's keep it going. Move those chains.
You know, I think if you look at the yardage for this game, we've actually, the offense moved the ball a reasonable amount.
They moved the ball from the 20 to the 20.
Yeah. And again, Sumner up the middle for another first down.
Well, the clock is still running, haven't given him the first down. That's most likely the last play of the game. 26-0. Lions come into Leary Field. They're going to try to get one more. They got it off.
Sumner again as he cuts up in the middle. This time he's met. And that'll be the game here as the Lions come up strong for the second year in a row, 26-0 against the Colonials here. And you know, I think we just take this and get a feel for this team speed that we saw tonight, Mark, and take this into practice this week and sort of reassemble and get ready now, knowing that we probably played about as good a team as we're going to play all season here tonight.
That's right. And you know that the bar is set very high, and when you get into the DCL, even the better DCL teams are not going to give you the challenge that that Chelsea gives you. And it's really, really ironic. There are so many situations where, you know, AB, since this rivalry began, they won the first 10, 11 games in a row, and now Chelmsford has won the last three. And it it seems to happen. Once a team breaks a streak, they start one of their own. So it's going to be a challenge for next year to play this team. And we're going to, you know, next week, we're going to regroup and get a W.
Terrific. Well, we'll see you next week, everybody. Thanks for coming out.